So today I'm trying to talk about a few shapes in spherical coordinates. Do you see this? If I'm looking at this a little line segment, and it could be a line, that line segment makes angle phi with respect to the vertical axis, whatever that vertical axis is. And I notice, oh, that vertical axis actually is Z in this case. So I'm looking at that, and I think about a volume of a rotation. So I start rotating that. And when I'm rotating that, I can see that you end up with a cone basically. And so here's the cone, and that's how it goes. Does phi always make a cone? Oh, a lot of times it makes a cone. Now I'm changing the phi. Look at this. If I rotate it again, I'm going to get a cone again. And then I can stop it again. Tighter cone, basically. I'm changing phi. Now let's go this way. And a little lower, 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 right there. Ooh, I missed it. I missed the chances. And so if I bring it up right about here, a little bit more maybe. There we go. Now, what am I trying to do? That like looks like a phi equal to pi half, and I start rotating it. Oh, what is going to happen? Oh, that is what's going to happen. And this is just a line segment that what it does. Let's say if it was an infinite line, it would be the entire XY plane basically. And so, yeah, you get a lot of chances of different values in there basically. For any phi other than, let's see, another phi that I want to show you is this phi. If it's also phi equal to zero, then you get just the z-axis. And for phi equal to pi half, you get the xy plane. And then for the phi equal to pi, you get the lower part of z-axis. Phi equal to zero, upper part of the z-axis, lower phi equal to pi, the lower part of z-axis, and pi half again, xy plane, and all the phis between other than these three, you're gonna get a cone, either upper nap of the cone or lower nap of the cone. So explore it a little bit.